more with Jen. 14 years ago, she came to this campus and we became an acquaintance. I would say friends. But, you know, Jen has this thing. She's always laughing. She's always making things very easy. She's always very, just full of life. One day in the ice machine, she came to me, we were alone, and she said to me, I just out of the blue, she told me her medical condition. That was 14 years ago, and I was shocked, so shocked. Because before this, not only that she's always so cheerful, she's always talking about God. Her faith is so rock solid. The day she told me about her medical condition, I said, Jem, how are you walking as a Christian every day? So loving, so giving, no bitterness in you whatsoever. How are you able to do that? And she said, because I know God. I trust God. That day, I become one of the people who admire her to this day. It's not just about her laughter, but she, and her courageous self going through her medical condition, but the way she loved. There's so much I want to say about her. I don't think I can say in one evening. Her love for 1300 is beyond your understanding. For the 14 years, she's always putting 1300 together. I know even I don't work there anymore, but she put together Christmas party, birthday party for you guys, potlucks. I'm sure you guys remember. I'm sure she has a way of making all of you very special. Despite her heartache, she felt rejection from time to time. She wanted to be charging us for a very, very valid reason. I'm sure nobody knows. Or maybe Josie and I know about it. But I wanted her to live telling her for the longest time. I said to Jem, you don't belong here. You need to be healthy. But she said, no. I want to be a charger so I don't have to have patient care. So I can still be 1300. I love my family here. She wouldn't need her BSN for years. She did her night shift coming home, so exhausted. She has to study, and she kept on going, and I wish that she stopped. There were times that she lived alone in her house, she would faint. Nobody knew, only I knew that. I said to Jeff, stop already, don't go to school. Just stop just for now. She said no. The reason is because she wanted to be able to be charged with her BSN, so she never have to go anywhere else. That's how much she loved all of you guys, 1300 colleagues. So many years ago, one night she called me, she said, Hannah, I decided to be a DNR. Why? You are young, you're a good candidate for whatever you need to do to be medically healthy again. She said, I don't want my family to be burdened by me. I'm sorry, Auntie. But that's how much she would love her family. I don't think I've met her brothers, but she always talked about her brothers. She always said, Hannah, your kids remind me of myself and my brother. I think it's Jerick. They're very, very close to each other. And she's so proud of her brother, who is a model. And he is so good looking. I don't know which one.
Jasper.
Because they're all good looking. Jasper, is that you?
Not anymore.
And on your wedding day, it must be your, because I saw your wedding. Mm. It's the happiest day of her life. She said it's her family time. Auntie, she was so happy. And I'm so happy she had the opportunity. When she finally decided to go for a procedure which was supposed to change her life, things took for the worse. And I was so sad. I was so sad for her. But I told her, Jem, keep going. There is a God who is bigger than you and I. Just keep going. If it is God's will, it's gonna happen. And you're gonna be able to find a good job. Maybe you'll go back to 1300 when somebody finally know who you are. Because I want to tell you, she was very heartbroken when she didn't get to work any longer than 1300. 4 weeks, 5 weeks after she had been in the hospital, she was fired from the hospital. Lomalina took away her insurance. She was heartbroken. I had no words to comfort her. But then I told her, just keep going. Forget about insurance, forget about anything else. Just take care of your health. When she finally took away the DNR, she wanted to leave. This thing happened. But you know what? I was in Scotland and she texted me. She said, Hannah, I'm in bed, I couldn't get up. She said, you're still unconscious, I see. But I'm so proud of you. I see that you're still so happy. You don't let your injury take away the joy of you being with children in your vacation. And I thought to myself, here is a woman on a deathbed. Just couldn't wake up, couldn't eat. And she find time to encourage me. What a human being, auntie. What a daughter you have. I was in San Francisco when I got a text from auntie. But before that, she texted me, she said, Hannah, pray for my mom especially. Pray for her, because I want her to know that there is God. And if anything happened to me, I will see her in heaven. Make sure she gets to heaven. That's what she said. I want to share a few things that she has written to me. A long time ago, when I was going through my divorce, I was going through the hardest time as you can all imagine. And she wrote this to me. She said, Hannah, God will never give you anything you cannot bear. Don't ever forget that. And He will never take anything away from us that He won't replace something better. Keep your faith strong and trust Him. We cannot see the future, but He can. And He promised to give us a life lived abundantly. You're trying to change things your way, now let Him do it. Leave everything in His hand. Stay close to God, and He will never leave you. I know that God has not left Jim. I'm sorry that I'm grieving. I guess we're all grieving. Not that we don't trust God, but that makes us very human. I want to remember this, that Jem is with God. That is not Jem. That is just the body that's left. It's just a shell. This beautiful person that we know is now Jesus. I can tell you now, I can tell you that because God said, in 2 Corinthians 12 verse 4, He said that you will be with me in paradise. The day you accept me, you will never, never die. You will never die. And Paul said, to live is Christ, to die is gain. What gain it will be to be with Christ right now in paradise. And now Jem is free from the sorrow, the pain, the tremendous pain that she had to go through the last few days before she went. I'm so privileged to have been her friend. Though I'm not there every time, all the time, like going out to eat, like Josie said, I'm so thankful. Every time I see on Facebook, she put where she goes with you guys. It makes me so happy. I always tell Jem, thank God. She appreciates all of you, but I want to mention a few people. Auntie and uncle, of course. Praise God for you in her life, her brothers. I'm so thankful because there were hours we would talk about you guys. Mimi, thank you. Thank you for all that you've done for her. For many times you guys have gone out to eat, places you guys enjoy. Josie, thank you. Where's Marianne? I don't know where's Marianne. I can't see right now, but you're very special to Josie and Neil. Thank you. And thank you to all of you. Thank you for the time.